Hello. So last time we have covered the venous system of the abdomen. Now we will cover the portal system of abdomen. Portal system. So basically this system is drainage for gut part. Small intestine, large intestine, rectum, cecum, colon. For this we have portal system. And another organs we have venous system, which drain into vena cava directly or indirectly. Then, so how this system form? We have first this is a large portal vein. There are some corresponding artery and veins. We have covered the arterial system in abdomen, so it is corresponding. This is superior mesenteric vein. This is superior mesenteric vein. Then this is portal vein. Sorry, this is portal vein. How it forms? We know here is pancreas present. This is pancreas. Then and this is neck portion of the pancreas. This is neck of pancreas. Then neck of pancreas. This is portal vein. So first vein it drained. Here we know splenic vein. A vein come here from spleen. Here we know spleen present behind the stomach. Stomach ke behind the spleen present hota hai. This vein come from spleen. So this is called splenic vein, and another vein comes from this end, ascending. This is called again this is behind of neck of pancreas. This is called splenic vein, and this is called superior mesenteric vein, corresponding to superior mesenteric artery. So this is spleen. This is splenic vein, and another is superior mesenteric vein. Superior बिल्कुल corresponding to superior mesenteric artery, same supply, same branches of the venous, let's say middle colic vein, ileocecal vein, all these are same branches, right colic vein, similar are vessels. We can draw. Then, let's say either here middle colic vein present. This is middle colic vein, some arcuate branches again. One branch is called right colic vein, and another is ileocecal vein. Ileocecal vein. Again, it has ascending branch and descending branch. Descending branch give four branches. Four branches what? Appendicular branch, appendicular vein, cecal vein, ileal vein, and cecal. Cecal vein divided to anterior, posterior, and ileal vein. Ileal vein, appendicular vein, cecal vein, and colon vein. Basically, what are veins? Basically, you can write this is ileal vein. Ileal vein. This is cecal vein. This is appendicular vein. Appendicular vein. And this is colic vein. Ileocolic vein bolte hai na sab. This is colic vein. These four veins basically same similar to a ileocolic artery. Similar pattern. No change. Done. Now come to another part. This is part of superior mesenteric vein. Supply the which part? Midgut part. Midgut part. We have no when midgut part includes descending posterior part, remaining part of duodenum except interior first 25 centimeter part. छोड़ दे बाकी सारे ड्यूडेनम, जेजुनम, इलियम, सीकम, अपेंडिक्स, ट्रांसवर्स को असेंडिंग कोलन एंड ट्रांसवर्स कोलन टू थर्ड पार्ट एंटीरियर टू थर्ड इनिशियल टू थर्ड पार्ट. सो दिस इज सिमिलर टू अगेन सुपीरियर मेसेंटरिक आर्टरी. दिस टू वेन्स कंबाइन एंड फॉर्म अ पोर्टल वेन. दिस इज पोर्टल वेन. दिस इज कॉल्ड पोर्टल वेन. Portal vein. Then this is the main portal vein which supply the organs. And another one important branch. This is superior mesentery vein. So inferior mesentery vein must also present here from this side. The vein come into splenic vein, which is called inferior mesenteric vein. This is called inferior mesenteric vein. This is called inferior mesenteric vein. Inferior mesenteric vein, which join into splenic vein and these drain into portal vein. This splenic, this inferior mesenteric vein again say have same force given to left poly branch, then it continues as superior rectal vein. Remember, this has similar force to inferior mesenteric artery. It gives a branch which is called left poly vein. This middle poly vein, right poly vein. We can write this is left colic colic vein. Then it again it has sigmoidal veins, many sigmoidal veins, rectal veins, and then it continue as this is sigmoidal veins and it is continue as finally superior rectal vein, similar to superior rectal artery. Superior rectal artery, rectal vein, which is continuation of inferior mesenteric vein. Rectal superior rectal vein. Done. This left colic vein and here iliac vein. Then this iliac vein. So it has similar corresponding course to approximately similar corresponding course to arteries. Similar. Superior mesenteric vein, inferior mesenteric vein, but important thing, no ciliate trunk present corresponding to artery. And so what about the stomach and esophagus part? So they are supplied by this. Remember, the ciliate trunk supply how, which organs? Liver. Ciliate trunk supply liver, stomach and lower part of esophagus. These supply by esophagus, these supply by ciliate trunk. So how they supply? Drain. First we know this portal vein go into liver, so it drain from liver, liver finish. Now come to the stomach. Stomach is supplied by how? Left and right gastric arteries or gastric vein बोल सकते हैं. We can say gastric vein here, left gastric vein, right gastric vein, left gastric epiploic vein or right gastric epiploic vein. These are four veins which drain into stomach. So how it forms? First, take this vein of spleen, Again, spleen has similar role. We can draw here from a slightly above. Let's say this is spleen. This is spleen. Done. And here is this. This is splenic vein. Splenic vein. So how it supplies the stomach? Remember, in splenic artery, it gives the left gastric epiploic artery. So again, splenic vein, it again gives into left gastric epiploic vein. Let's say, here is a stomach present. This is stomach, remember? So again, this is left gastric epiploid vein, which is supplied by splenic vein, and again splenic vein gives some short gastric artery similar to short gastric vein. So these are supplied by stomach. How splenic vein gives short gastric arteries, short gastric veins, splenic vein gives into short gastric veins. Short gastric vein by splenic vein, and again this is left gastric epiploid vein. Left gastric epiploid vein. Done. Left gastric epiploid vein, similar to artery. Now come to the right gastric epiploid vein. This is left gastric epiploid vein. So how right gastric epiploid vein come? It comes from superior mesenteric artery vein. Superior mesenteric vein give right gastric epiploid vein, which anastomoses with left and supply the greater curvature of the stomach. Greater curvature. It supplies the greater curvature of the stomach. So this is again right gastric epiploid. Epiploid. Vein from superior mesenteric vein, then which supply the greater curvature of the stomach. But what about the lesser curvature? In lesser curvature we have left gastric artery and right gastric artery. So here we have similar left gastric vein or right gastric vein. But how this comes? These both come from the portal vein. This is left gastric vein. And this is right gastric vein. Here this anastomose. This is again one anastomose. These are the anastomoses. Done. This is, and again we know left gastric artery supply the gives some esophageal branches, esophageal arteries. So again left gastric vein gives some esophageal veins. Similar to artery. These are esophageal veins which supply the inferior part of the esophagus. Then this is left gastric vein, right gastric vein. This is right gastric vein. Both come from portal vein. No change. Gastric vein. And one is left gastric vein. This is left gastric vein. Left gastric vein, similar to left gastric artery. Both these come from the similar part. Both these come from portal vein. Done. Now, what about the liver? These portal vein again drain into liver. But how it drains into liver? It divides into two branches. Left gastric vein, right left hepatic, left and right portal vein, left and right branches into. Done. Left and right branch basically. This is right branch of liver and left vein of liver. Here liver present, we know. Let's say here is liver present. Done. So these are the portal vein branches which go into liver. This is left branch and right branch. This is right and this is left. We can write. Right branch of portal vein. Portal vein. And this is left branch of portal vein. Left branch of portal vein, which again drain into liver. In previous class, we have studied the hepato-intestinal portal system. So this is the portal system. Note this. So this is the portal system. Now come to the one important vein, which is called prepyloric vein of Hume. We have learned this wave in pyloric sphincter region. A vein which is present anterior to duodenum at pyloric region. Just pyloric sphincter, which is called prepyloric vein of Hume. And with what is it connect? Superior mesenteric vein to right gastric vein. It is an important vein. This is. Draw like this. This is prepyloric vein of Hume. It connects the superior mesenteric vein to right gastric vein just anterior to duodenum. Anterior to duodenum, which is called prepyloric vein of Hume. We can write here prepyloric vein of mu, prepyloric vein of mu, present in pyloric sphincter region. This again, these are different veins. It connects the superior mesenteric vein to right gastric vein, which is present inferior anterior to duodenum. Let's say here is duodenum present. This is stomach and duodenum. So it goes, and here is duodenum, sphincter region present, pyloric region, this is pyloric region of duodenum, this is pyloric region of duodenum, it present in pyloric sphincter region from stomach. So done. This is duodenum part, remember. We can write here. Right here. Pyloric sphincter. Sphincter of duodenum. Duodenum. Done. You can write slightly near पोस्टीरियर मेसेंटेरिक वेन एंड दिस इज पाइलोरिक स्फिंक्टर ऑफ ड्यूओडेनम एंड दिस प्री पाइलोरिक वेन प्रेजेंट एंटीरियर टू इट एंड कनेक्ट्स द सुपीरियर मेसेंटेरिक वेन टू राइट गैस्ट्रिक वेन. So this is the whole portal system. Now what up again here? This vein into liver and again a vein come out from liver which is called hepatic vein. This drain into again inferior vena cava. Now last vein come which is called hepatic vein. Vein come out. This vein is called hepatic vein, which drain into inferior vena cava. Hepatic vein. Done. So this is whole portal system presenting abdomen, which supply the abdominal organs. Portal system organs. Then this is the whole portal supply of the abdomen. Note this whole things. So next part is the portocaval anastomosis. This is the portal system. Next we have draw the venous system. So there are some points in which attachments of venous system and portal system occur. These points are called portocaval anastomosis. Let's say, and where is the portal system? This is vena cava, inferior vena cava, diaphragmatic branches. It has many branches supply and renal branches, that's all, nine branches. And the final, it divide into two branches. This is venous system. We can draw venous system slightly. Let's say this is inferior diaphragmatic branches. In chest area, we have some branches which is called azygous vein, hemiazygous vein, these are, and some thoracic, again thoracic also. So thoracic vein, let's say this thoracic vein. There are points here, portal system and venous system combined. So in thoracic region, we know some esophageal veins come out, similar to esophageal arteries. Similar to esophageal arteries, esophageal veins also come from this azygous vein. We know azygous vein present here. So here we draw azygous vein. Let's say we can draw azygous vein from this. This is azygous vein. This azygous vein give thoracic branches, many thoracic branches, and from this thoracic vena cava, some give esophageal branches, esophageal veins. From thoracic vena cava, remember. And here we know esophageal. In thoracic region we have azygous vein and some part, some vena cava part. So in inferior vena cava give some thoracic branches, thoracic veins, and which supply the esophagus lower part. This is esophageal veins. These are esophageal branches. Esophageal branches. IVC sent from IVC. And these are the esophageal branches from left gastric vein. So this is the site of portocaval anastomosis. First, site of portocaval anastomosis. Esophageal branches from in vena cava, vena cable system. This is called cable system. And portal vein from left gastric vein. This is a site of portocaval anastomosis. You can write esophageal branches from IVC. This is our IVC. And these esophageal branches from these branches come from left gastric vein. Basically, portal vein. Left gastric vein. From left gastric vein. This is part of portocaval system, portal system. So here esophageal branches from IVC and here esophageal branches from portal system. This is called portocaval anastomosis. Here portal system and cable system combined. This is cable system. Cable system. Basically cable system is venous system from IVC. IVC. Done. This is first point. And here we know these divide into common iliac veins. Again, common iliac veins divide into two branches. These common iliac branch, this divide into two branches, external and internal iliac veins. This external and this is internal. Internal iliac veins give branches to the rectum, similar to arteries. Remember, inferior internal iliac artery has middle rectal vein and middle rectal artery and inferior rectal artery. So here it gives middle rectal artery and inferior rectal artery. This is internal iliac vein. It gives branch. This is branch which is called middle rectal vein, and one branch of this is called, these are branches, this is called internal pudendal artery, pudendal vein, similar to pudendal artery. Internal pudendal vein, this give branch called inferior rectal vein. This is middle rectal vein, and remember this is superior rectal vein, which is continuation of inferior mesenteric artery. This is middle rectal vein come from branch of middle rectal vein, and from internal pudendal artery a branch come which is called inferior rectal vein. So this is part of again cable system, and this superior rectal vein comes from portal system. This is superior rectal vein. Superior rectal vein. And here, so this is again part of second portocaval anastomosis system. This is second point. Now, this is second point. Now come to the third point. Third point is at umbilicus region. Remember umbilicus region. Umbilicus is the navel part. Now first, let's say this is umbilicus. This is umbilicus. So basically these are the two sides of portocaval anastomosis. Now come to the umbilicus. There are three points in umbilicus. First, just at the umbilicus, a vein come which go into liver in embryonic stage, which is called प्री अम्बिलिकल विच इज कॉल्ड अम्बिलिकल वेन. वी कैन ड्रॉ अम्बिलिकल वेन लाइक दिस. दिस इज अम्बिलिकल वेन इन एम्ब्रियोनिक स्टेज. सो दिस ओनली प्रेजेंट इन एम्ब्रियोनिक स्टेज. दिस इज अम्बिलिकल वेन विच गो इन टू लिवर डन. एंड दिस इज पार्ट ऑफ अगेन दिस पार्ट ऑफ पोर्टल सिस्टम. बिकॉज अम्बिलिकल वेन कनेक्ट इन टू पोर्टल वेन सम पार्ट. एंड वेयर वी नो इन थोरेसिक रीजन सम ब्रांचेस ऑफ इंटरकोस्टल वेन्स फ्रॉम थोरेसिक रीजन. वी हैव इंटरकोस्टल वेन्स थोरेसिक रीजन. इंटरकोस्टल वेन कम फ्रॉम एसाइगस वेन बेसिकली केवल पार्ट इंटरकोस्टल वेन्स. So this is again part of portal cotogenous because umbilical vein is part of portal system and intercostal branches come from the cable system. This part of again third site of cotogenous. This is umbilical vein. Umbilical vein, and these are the intercostal veins. Thoracic intercostal veins. Intercostal veins. Done. So this side of third anastomosis. Now come to their clinical part. Sometimes some veins get blocked, so their corresponding anastomose get involved, means dilated, most dilated, dilate ho jayega. Also it is more visible, which is called at umbilical region it is called caput medusae. Clinical caput medusae. In which portal vein blocked, other veins get engorged. Delicate basically. So from umbilical region they come out like this. They view like this. From umbilical region these veins visible like this. So this is called caput medusae. Another clinical part is rectal part. From rectal part this is called hemorrhoids, in which portal vein get blocked. So their corresponding veins dilated and some bleeding can also occur in this region. This is called hemorrhoids. Here, this first part. Here is second part. Second part is hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids. In rectal region. This is for rectal region. Basically. Here is rectal region. Hemorrhoids. It occur in rectal region. Hemorrhoids. Some bleeding occur due to again hoga to is this is the main reason portal vein block. Rectal region. Bleeding occur during stool passing. So this is second part. Another clinical is present in third point. Here. Another anomaly present. So third clinical case is esophageal varices. Gel varices, in which again the veins near the esophagus dilated due to portal hypertension. Portal veins get blocked, so esophageal compresses. Esophagus compresses, and here some bleeding also occurs. So it is called esophageal. Here veins near esophagus. Near esophagus dilated and esophagus and bleeding occur. Bleeding will be. Esophagus also compress. Esophagus can also compress. Esophagus also compress. Then so these are the three points of portocarial anastomosis and their corresponding clinical cases. Now come to the fourth portocarial anastomosis site. Fourth portocarial anastomosis site is behind the liver. We can draw liver here like this. Let's say this is liver. Liver, which part? Posterior side. We can draw posterior side of the liver. Let's say this is liver original position. If we rotate the liver, let's say if we rotate the liver like this, so it will look like this. Normal liver is present here, major part is present here, and go like this. So if we rotate the liver, posterior side, this is posterior side of liver. Now we know portal vein drain into liver, so this portal vein, and here is inferior vena cava also present. This is inferior vena cava. This is portal vein. This is portal vein, and this is inferior vena cava. This is IVC. Here is a direct branch which connect with these two, which is called, this branch is called ductus venosum. This is presenting embryonic stage. If we grow, it convert into ligamentum venosum. Then remaining present out there in embryonic. This is embryonic stage part. So this is site of fourth portocarial anastomosis. Then note this. This site of portocarial anastomosis fourth. Three cover here and fourth. Note this. So basically we have covered the four portocaval anastomosis sites. Now come to the another some important portocaval anastomosis sites. Portocaval anastomosis. Portocaval anastomosis. Four we have covered. Now come to the another. One is present at bare area of liver. How? Portal vein branch from portal system. We draw this system like this. Let's say this is side, this is portal part of So anastomosis and here is this is portal part. Here is cable part. Done. And here the right side. First side is bare area of liver. Bare area of liver. Portal vein branch. We can write. Portal vein branch and here is inferior diaphragmatic branch. Inferior diaphragmatic branch. Done. This first again. In embryonic stage, remember, liver have three sides of portobello anastomosis. Two covered, one behind the liver, which is called ductus venosum, bare of liver, and one is at front. One is at falciform ligament. Falciform ligament. Done. Here we have pre-umbilical vein, umbilical vein, and here is vena cava branch. IVC branches. Basically, hepatic vein branches. Basically, IVC, hepatic vein branches. Hepatic vein branches. Done. And three is ductus venosum. We can write here. Three. Now comes to the one is present in posterior wall, posterior abdominal wall, posterior. Abdominal wall, posterior abdominal wall. Here is part of branch of splenic vein, branch of splenic vein, vein, and here is branch of IVC. Basically region yaad rakhna hai, basically present in splenic region, near spleen. It present near spleen. Done. Spleen. Done. Four we have covered, three are these. Now total now is 7. Now again, there is present, one is present in vaginal region. Vaginal region. Some vaginal branches come from here and some come from here. This is present in women basically. Branch from rectum. Branch from rectum, inferior rectal vein, inferior rectal vein, inferior sorry, inferior mesenteric vein, mesenteric vein, and here is branch from. Remember, similar branching pattern of abdominal aorta. One branch comes from, remember, internal iliac artery. One branch is called vaginal branch, which is inferior, superior, inferior vesicular vein. Basically, branch of IVC, something, inferior branch of you can write branch of IVC, but which vaginal branch? Vaginal branch. Then another side is one we have covered the umbilical region, one present above the umbilical. Above umbilical, umbilicus. Above umbilicus present superior mesenteric. Basically, here we present portal vein, because umbilical is the portal vein present, and another here branch from IVC, just center branch. Some IVC branches are also connected, basically, umbilical branch, many branches. Portal vein, branch of IVC. Done. And one present below umbilicus. Again, portal vein and same branch of IVC. So basically, these are another six sides of portocaval nostrumosa. Four we have covered are, one we can write here. Let's say this is seven. Six is present here. Umbilicus. Umbilicus mein. Umbilical, pre-umbilical vein. Umbilical vein. Basically, umbilical vein present in embryonic region. Now it has remnant, which is called pre-umbilical vein. And here, intercostal branches. Intercostal branches. Intercostal veins. Done. Another, we have covered sites are, one is present here. Posterior surface liver. Posterior liver surface. Posterior liver surface, what part? A common portal vein and IVC, complete IVC. Inferior IVC, diabetic vein. And what connect these two? Ductus venosum, remember. Ductus venosum. Again present in embryonic stage. So these sides of three sides of liver, these three sides of umbilicus. Now one we have covered, lower part of esophagus. Remember, lower part of esophagus, not all. Lower part of esophagus. Lower part of esophagus from left gastric vein. You can write left gastric vein and here from esophageal branches from IVC. Esophageal branches. Basically from IVC. IVC. The and one side we have covered the rectal part. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Rectal part. Rectal region. Rectal region. Rectal region have superior rectal vein, and here is middle and inferior rectal vein. Done. So basically these are 10 sides of portocarp anastomosis. We can draw here like this. Basically these are the 10 sides of portocarp anastomosis, corresponding vein, corresponding portal part, corresponding cable part. These are important portocarp anastomosis sides. So basically these are the 10 portocarp anastomosis sides. You can note this. Next time we will cover organs of the body.